We wanted to give everyone on Kickstarter a full walkthrough of the prototype Olympian, talk about its function, some of its features, the material selection, and some of the differences you can expect to see from this prototype version compared to the landed production model. All right, let's start with the real housing. You may notice that we decided on a real up design that has two driving factors. Number one, it allows for clearance of your vehicle hatch, so you're not limiting when or how you can access your car. The other reason is to prevent snagging of your eyelets. You're combining the real up design with our latex rod tube that runs the length of the aluminum, and when you're putting your fly rod in or taking it out, you're not going to snag up on your eyelets, damage your equipment, or just overall get annoyed. The Olympian's also equipped with a spring-assisted door. So when you're opening and accessing it, it not only is spring-assisted, but it holds the lid up, so it's not in the way where you're trying to load your rod and reel inside.
So one of the other things we want to mention is the material. All of the plastic components on the Olympian are made out of glass-filled nylon. Glass-filled nylon is the same kind of material you see used on major roof rack accessories.
So that brings us to real protection. For our prototype, we used a closed-cell kayak foam for proof of concept. And we learned that real protection is crucial for the type of abuse that we want the Olympian to withstand. But we also learned that the kayak foam, although it offers great protection of the reel, it's a bit too soft to withstand the type of high frequency use that we want our product to be capable of. When you start seeing that constant in and out motion that it's encountering, we started seeing an awful lot of dings and dents in the foam. So we went back to the drawing board, and in the production model, you're gonna see that the padded reel insert is a custom molded single piece of Santoprene material. And Santoprene, just to give you an idea, is the same type of material you see in most newer vehicles' door seals. It's super soft, it's weather resistant, and it's incredibly durable, and it has a really long lifespan.
So we've opted to use 6061 aerospace grade aluminum. Everyone's heard those words before. And you can see, you know, on the outside of our prototype, there's, you know, a bunch of scuffs and scrapes because we've been beating the crap out of it. And this is a result of using off-the-shelf components for this prototype. Doing that allowed us to keep the cost down. These prototype components don't have any surface finish on them. They're just raw aluminum. You can see they've got sharp corners on them. That's something that's gonna change in the production version. It also lets us shrink the footprint of these tubes down. So the overall dimensions of the product are gonna get smaller and more compact. It also gets lighter by having control over the wall thickness in the tubes. We can make the whole product lighter. We're shaving, you know, pounds off of this thing.
So the tubes expand and contract using a telescopic design, and they do so with custom molded bushings that allow for an engineered sliding fit and added rigidity in the system. Each bushing has a button that is depressed to extend and hold the tube in position. And when fully collapsed, these tubes have a locking button on the housing so you can control when the Olympian is extended.
So our nose piece is made from the same glass-filled nylon material as the housing, and it serves a few specific functions. First, it's used as a grabbing point for telescoping the tubes. It's securely riveted to the inner aluminum tube, so when you begin extending the Olympian, it makes sure that you have a tactile point to grab, as well as ensuring that the inside tube moves first. And most importantly, it looks pretty sweet in the collapsed and extended mode.
Something not shown on this prototype is the final attachment point for the shoulder strap. We wanted to test the center of gravity of our shoulder strap before deciding on final attachment points. Now that the testing is over, we've selected precise locations to attach the shoulder strap while it's in carry mode. Those locations will be up here with a pin, as well as a molded in section on the nose piece. All right, so the rod sleeve. This was a big challenge for us from the very beginning. We wanted something that would fully protect your fly rod in the collapsed and extended and rigged modes. And we needed it to protect not just from moisture, but from the banging around on the inside of the aluminum tubes while you travel on things like washboard dirt roads and over river rock. We worked with our manufacturer partner to develop a custom engineered latex material that is dip molded into a tubular section and allows for over a 500% stretch rating, tear resistant walls, and it has exceptional element protection. The tube runs the length of the Olympian, and it actually suspends the fly rod in the middle of the aluminum sections, acting as a damping or suspension system on those rough roads. So your rod will never smack into the metal sides or catch on its eyelets. You can actually see a 3D model of this part on the product page as a GIF on our Kickstarter site. And finally, our quick clamps. We've gone through a lot of different iterations before we finally got something that satisfied all of our parameters that we were looking for. These clamps are sleek, they store inside the lid while in carry mode, and they take seconds to set up. In the production model, the first three tubes will have mounting tracks, so you have plenty of options on the mounting location and the crossbar spacing. And we match the two lock cores on these clamps with the same lock cores that you see on the button as well as the lid of the housing. So one key and it does it all. So let's talk about the geometry of the clamps. This geometry was designed to fit around round, square, and arrow style crossbars. So you're not gonna be stuck without a mounting option for your ride. The clamp arm that's shown in this prototype are actually 3D printed stainless steel. And after testing this on multiple vehicles, we decided that using a glass-filled nylon arm would be lighter weight, and for this function, it's just as durable and handles the needed clamping force that we need compared to a metal option. They also eliminate any concern about damaging or marring the surface of your existing vehicle crossbars.